personality like Swami Gautamananda ji. Personalities like Swami Kamalatmananda ji. I was his edupudi, literally for Kamalatmananda ji. I was his student, brahmachari. When he dictates, I will take notes, and actually I learnt literally Tamil from him. Writing, reading, everything is giant. But his humbleness, I should put this on record. After I started my own organization and became a guru, known all over the world, I went to Madurai. Madurai, we had a large satsang. I think in Raja Muttaya Hall. Hall was full. And the song to welcome me, the welcome song was played. And on the stage, there was a huge throne. I walked into my hall to give my satsang. The whole Madurai, thousands of posters, flyers. I was walking into the hall with a humble bowed. The way I walk with a humble namaskar and bowing down, suddenly I saw one saffron clothed Swami sitting in the audience. Audience, not on the stage. Audience. I was shocked. I looked deeply. I saw Swami Kamalatmanandaji. We did not invite him. I should have actually invited him formally and had a simhasan for him on the stage. But somehow I was very reluctant. Will he come if I invite? And even if he comes, will he have any difficulty or any disturbance from the organization side? Or you see, Ramakrishna Mission is a large organization. There are many isms, means some may not fully agree with the way I am working. And I had my own thoughts, so I did not invite him. I was shocked when I saw him sitting in audience. I just straight went and fell at his feet and said, his extreme humbleness. He just slapped me on the back. Hey, nalla pesuriyan paakradhukaga vandanda. Poda poda stage la poi okkarra. He told in Tamil in singular. He nicely slapped me on the back. That's the way he relates with me. I relate with him like I am his son and he is my father, and he is literally giant. And onnalada nalla pesuriyan paakradhukaga vandanda. He said that in singular. I just came to see how you are talking. Go, go, go and sit in the stage. I said, nothing doing. I cannot sit in front of you. In the stage or the throne, I will shiver. I cannot speak. You please better sit in the throne. I made him sit in the main throne, and side I put a separate chair for me. I sat in that chair and gave the public satsang. This is the only satsang you will see in my whole 26 years of public life where I will not be in the main throne. I will be in the side throne. We have the photographs and videographs. I will pull it out. I will be in the side in a small chair and giving the satsang. Swamiji will, Kamalatmananji will be the main throne in Madurai. In Raja Sir Muttaya Hall, the satsang was organized, and actually till that time many people did not even know that I am from Ramakrishna Mission background. I said, nothing doing, no question of sitting in the throne in front of you. It will be, not only I don't have a guts to speak in front of you, it will be droha to the guru parampara. I might have left the organization, but I cannot leave the guru parampara. You see, organization is different and guru parampara is different. I can't leave the Guru Parampara or I can't disrespect the Guru Parampara. That's why the first ashram I created, I dedicated it to Sri Ramakrishna. I cannot disrespect Guru Parampara. He did not agree. He said, no, you have to sit in the stage. It's a satsang organized on your name and people have come to listen to you, not to me. I said, nothing doing. You have come. I cannot sit in front of you in throne. You better sit in the throne. I will sit next to you in the side. I'll put a separate chair. I put a separate chair and sat on that. And he sat in the throne. And in the satsang itself, I said, I am just an ordinary small boy in front of Swamiji, giant-like personalities, Swami Kamalatmanandaji. His Shiva Bhakti, oh God. He is a real Bhakta, real devotee I have seen in my life. His commitment, extreme, sincere, integrated commitment.